we are a little less than 10 miles inland from the blue waters of the Pacific Ocean as we greet you from lovely San Diego, California. Tonight, on this fine Thursday night, we've got a good one in store between the Denver Broncos and the San Diego Chargers. Backfield is Gordon, and they'll give it to him here, and he'll get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. Melvin Gordon, a receiving touchdown in the loss to the Raiders on the ground, 16 carries, 69 yards.
So that's over 4 yards a carry. That's the type of production you're looking for, and that's what they drafted, and they're getting it in year two with Melvin Gordon, and then the ability to throw it to him as well. That only increases what they can do with him on offense.
Now a second down throw for Rivers. And it's complete to Antonio Gates. And he's brought down after a good game. A big game that time for the Chargers. 35 yards.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line, and then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the older reliable, you're right, just one of 9 players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. Now Gordon on first down. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Melvin Gordon's rookie year was a far cry from his last season at Wisconsin, wasn't it?
Boy, it was. Yeah, we got the numbers right here. 3.5 yards per carry, 641 yards, no touchdown.
Well, I think his team is really looking to do things to help him break out and get back to that Wisconsin form in 2016.
Rivers now on second down. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for 3rd and 4. From the gun, Rivers. In man, able to bring it in. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
On 1st and 10, Rivers. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
On 2nd down, they'll run with Gordon. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10. Here's Rivers. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now 4th down.
But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game, I'm going to show them this play. Because they couldn't get to the passer. So what do you have to do? Get your hands up in the passing lane. And they batted it away on a 3rd down attempt.
And Lambeau will put this one through, and the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. So they get the ball first here in front of the home crowd, under the lights, and they get 3 points out of it.
And there's something about a night game, isn't there? A little extra snap, a little extra crisp in the air. What a terrific way to get things started. A little extra excitement, a little extra dazzle for the home crowd.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And Denver getting set to take the field. C.J. Anderson, and he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. Anderson against the Falcons, 41 yards on 11 carries, and you know, you total up the numbers, 84 carries this year, 3.5 per.
And what they're used to getting from C.J. Anderson is 3.5 yards per carry. That part, this is kind of normal, but they're also used to getting that big home run shot from him. All right, you remember against New England in 2015, he finished that game in the snow with a big jaunt. They need more of that, him being able to get to the third level into the secondary.
They brought him in off the corner, and he gets in to drop him for a loss of 4.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on 3rd and 14. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking deep for Demarius. And a shot taken on 3rd down, unsuccessful. 4th down now.
Well, it bounced up after taking a sack and took a shot downfield. I think a lot of us thought maybe he'd run draw in that situation instead. Tried to get all back in one play.
Yeah, 3rd and long, thought he needed the deep pass, couldn't connect it.
Maybe he was hoping for a penalty downfield to give him the yardage they needed.
Now Benjamin. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Out comes the San Diego offense as they get set to see what they can do here. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Couple of Broncos there in on the tackle.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on 1st down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down, Rivers. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. Back now to begin the 2nd quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football. They'll come up on a 3rd and 4 here to start things out. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. And he gets this one across midfield for the 1st down to the 46. And there on 3rd and short, they just tried to spread the field. It worked.
And I think that the spreading of the field, the extra receivers, has really become the next in the evolutionary chain in the NFL. Go all the way back in that situation, you're handed to the fullback, right? As we evolve, maybe you pitched it to your tailback. Now you spread the field, and you have your choices of where to throw it and complete it for a 1st down.
That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
When we did DeMarcus Ware's games in Dallas, didn't we spend most of the time talking about him rushing the passer?
We did, and how about now?
Oh, boy, he's expanded his game in a big way. Really does a great job in the run game now, using his length, using his leverage to hold the point of attack and make plays as we just saw there.
They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon, and he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a 3rd and 8.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. 1st level defensive line, 2nd level linebackers, 3rd level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a 1st level run, and it was stopped by a 2nd level player.
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this 3rd and 8. Working out of the gun, Rivers. And underneath here to McCluster. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
One man in the backfield is Gordon. He'll get the football here. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he's got some space here. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Partner, I was fortunate enough to see Melvin Gordon throughout his college career. And what I liked the most about him, he always added something to his game. He went from being what I called a gimmick runner, a lot of jet sweeps and things of that nature, to being a full-time, three-down back who can make big plays at any time.
Big plays indeed from Kenosha, Wisconsin. High school teammate of?
Say it.
Trey Waynes.
How about that? Pretty good right there.
Yeah,
good two
combo.
Of those guys end up in the NFL.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. A first down throw here for Rivers. Benjamin with it over the middle. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Early in the year, Keenan Allen goes out with the injury. That puts Travis Benjamin in the number one role receiving-wise. 117 yards against the Raiders. He looked like a number one target.
And normally with Keenan Allen out, you would think Phillip Rivers would look to Antonio Gates, but he hasn't been 100% throughout the entire season. So he stayed out on the perimeter, and Travis Benjamin raised his hand and said, I'm in. I'll be your new number one.
Rivers. This will be caught at about the 5. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up 1st and goal.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
From the gun, Rivers. And he's got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Travis Benjamin from 4 yards out. And the Chargers are going to add on to their lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it's a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you would have
that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll be 2nd down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now Simeon. He goes underneath for Anderson. Muscles him off. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense has it first and 10. Simeon into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Down. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. First down, Rivers. Right side catch. This is Gates. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now a second down throw for Rivers. This one caught by Griff Whalen. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
From the red zone now, Rivers. Inman has it over the middle. And he's brought down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Safety, TJ Ward. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
Okay, Larry, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll be first down Denver.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Down. Here's the run with Anderson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Let's go! Boo, Landon!
Again, Anderson. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. And that right there will set him back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? The guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send a blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
Now Simeon. And he will find his man for the first time, Demaryius Thomas. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Now we'll look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Play fake to Gordon. Now Rivers. It's hauled in here by Edmund. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Well, showed a little athletic juke, but then the daylight quickly closed. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second down, Rivers. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
One man in the backfield is Gordon. The pigskin on the 7-yard line now. It's first and goal. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M, and all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me, his balance and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
They come out here in the eye. Now Rivers going to give it off to Gordon. Gordon loses the football. It's loose.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Now they've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal? They'll try and run it in with McCluster. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
And that loss of yards there is not just on him. It's on the guys blocking for him. I mean, they're supposed to create some type of space or at least get a stalemate. They end up letting them through, and they ended up tackling him for a loss.
And we're back now in Mission Valley and San Diego. It's Charger football, and they've got the lead as well as we begin the 4th quarter. And Lambeau one through, and that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This will be taken in at the one. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Simeon. And his throw here is incomplete. He was looking for Jordan Norwood that time. And it's second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And a sideline pass that's caught by Thomas. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
He's come a long way since his time at Georgia Tech. What did he run at Tech? He ran hitches and go routes, essentially.
Yeah.
I mean, but he ran them really well. He averaged well over 20 yards a catch while he was there. And he still creates downfield in the NFL. That big body and that willingness to go catch the football. He's pretty impressive.
And his friends call him Bebe, the nickname his uncle gave him back in the day. And he fends him off. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The rookie from Ohio State, Joey Bosa, in there to bury him for a loss of 11. It's a five-receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. He'll look to throw. And complete into the hands of Fowler. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. The Broncos unable to convert here on fourth. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. The Chargers offense gets set. They head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you'll only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you one or two more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
So it'll be first down here after the run. A first down throw here for Rivers. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bronco offense now set to come back out onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now Simeon. Sanders has it over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, 22. And quickly, they get to the line. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Throwing right side, that's complete, Demaryius Thomas. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. So holding by the offense, and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
So 20 yards to go here on first down. They'll come out in the pistol. Simeon looking again for Thomas, this time complete, and now a fumble, the ball's out, so they almost turn it over there. Scary moment. Second down here, looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So second and 8 here after the penalty. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
As if he didn't have enough to think about on that route, the comeback route, coming back to the football and catching it, still had to make sure he toe-tapped and kept himself in bounds.
And that was spectacular, but on the comeback route, maybe a little easier to deal with the sideline since you've got better vision of it?
I think that's a great point, because you should know exactly where you're going and know how much space you have and make sure you get your feet down. But yeah, coming back to the football, I like it. Good vision.
And he's brought down after a good game. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll look to throw here on first down. Surveying the field. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Movement there on the offensive line. A little quick and a 5-yard penalty. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll look to throw again. Drops it underneath for Booker. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be third and 10 now. And now they're in the hurry up. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Now a desperation, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now San Diego getting set to go. Defensively, there's still three timeouts. Do you even need to use them at this point? Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The busy night continues for Gordon as he gets it here. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Let's go, D. Let's go, D. So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Now here's a whistle and a timeout. It's called by the receiving team here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Here's Drew Kazer now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And it's fielded at the 34. So Charles are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.